Tom O'Neill, the envelope with one of the greatest Oscar seers on the planet, Peter Travers.
I should have my turban. I should have something ready to do this. Where's Karger? You know, he's the guy.
You don't need Dave Karger. Right, this is how good Peter is. Couple years ago when Gladiator won Best Picture, Traffic had won at the New York Film Critics Circle. Mm-hmm. Everybody was saying that was going to win Best Picture. And I remember getting a phone call from a producer at Access Hollywood saying, Tom, can you find me anybody who's not predicting Traffic at the Golden Globes? Well, Peter Travers was the only person that I know back then who actually nailed Gladiator that early as the Globes and Oscar frontrunner. How did you know?
I just had that feeling through the crystal ball. No, there's sometimes an appetite in the Academy and the Golden Globes for an epic. They just love it. They want that again. They want it to be 1959, where Ben-Hur is the gigantic winner of everything. And they had it there, and they had a great performance by Russell Crowe at the center of it. So that's the appetite that's still out there. Don't you think that people want epic, 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 epic?
If they do this year, then it's Benjamin Button, isn't it? Because
it
that's
certainly
the, because
is.
Sometimes what we're talking about here is that fascinating thing about Oscar voters where they confuse big picture with best picture, and big this year is Button, right?
It's so big because everyone expects that will get the most nominations. But Tom, what I'm looking for is the surprise, the shock.
All right, but you know these because you're Mr. You know, call it early. What's the surprise
going to
be?
Well, yeah, because I see that it's going to be Benjamin Button versus Slumdog Millionaire, the movie that they've kind of taken to their hearts. We all kind of have. It's that movie. I've taken a movie called Milk to heart, so I'm happy that it's nominated because we're here at the New York Film Critics where it won. You know, but you get Frost Nixon in there, and then you only have that fifth slot. Is it Dark Knight? Is it Doubt? Or is it Wall-E? That's the surprise I would like to see happen. I would like to see an animated movie that's on every critic's 10 best list that the people seem to love actually break through that ghetto of animated movie and be nominated as Best Picture. Why can't it happen? Why don't you make it happen?
I'm not in the same league as you, Peter. You've been doing this a few years more than me. But I think it's possible for it to get in there. I think that given the preferential ballot, it has enough strong support. And how I think it's different from Ratatouille last year, which remember, at the end of each year, an animated movie was the highest scoring movie at Metacritic. All you critics gave...
That's right. So he's up.
Gave Ratatouille the highest score, and this year it's Wall-E. But Wall-E's not a rat. I think Ratatouille had that rat thing against him. You know, he's not a rodent,
not
Wall-E.
A rat.
So I think
he's a robot, he's binoculars, and we love him.
Yeah.
That's the love story of the year. What's the better love story?
You're right.
Kate and Leo are miserable in Revolutionary Road. We need somebody where when they hold hands, we go, ah. And that movie does it.
So is there any big jaw-dropping upset that could happen?
I think the upset that could happen is somebody who deserves to be nominated who doesn't get nominated. I worry about Clint Eastwood and Gran Torino because I think it is a symbolic performance of everything he represents. And I would like to see him nominated. But look, SAG didn't think he deserved the nomination. They didn't give it to him.
Neither did the Globes.
So what's going on there?
but the last
Sally
time that
Hawkins, the winner of our award, I don't know how she's going over with Academy members or not. I don't know. And I think that would be a shame to see those two not nominated. But it could happen. The shock could happen. Yeah.
And the winner will be on Oscar night?
For which category?
Best Picture.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say Slumdog Millionaire.
Best Actor?
Sean Penn.
Yes, I think that's a slam dunk. Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah. Best actress?
And best actress right now, I think, is between Meryl Streep in Doubt. And I used to think Kate Winslet, and now I'm thinking Anne Hathaway.
Yeah.
There's a kind of strength. There's something bubbling up about Anne Hathaway, low these many months after the release of Rachel Getting Married.
And she plays a lunatic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That always works.
A psycho. They always give it to that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, I think she's just a drug addict and an alcoholic. I don't know. How lunatic she is.
Right. She's crazy because of substance abuse.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think you've nailed it.
And then how do you not give Heath Ledger the posthumous Oscar?
You tell Spencer Tracy that. You tell James Dean that. Those other dead stars who everyone thought was going to win and then they didn't on Oscar night.
You know what? When Spencer Tracy didn't win for that, or James Dean didn't win, or all that happened, what Heath Ledger's doing, though, is giving a really, really good performance that I think deserves that attention. The Oscars have to represent more, I think, than the idea that he'll get a bigger paycheck for his next movie, which we know isn't going to happen. It should be what goes in the time capsule, and he deserves to go in the time capsule.
The end of Guess Who's Coming to Dinner was pretty powerful.
Catherine Hepburn, they were able to give the award to Catherine Hepburn as if you're alive, you can represent him in it. That wasn't her best performance by a long shot, but that was how they were awarding him.
It's a real insight.
Yeah.
I like to do that. Occasional insight is good.
I'm counting on you for a steer on the way this time. Okay? Thanks, Peter.
Thank you.